copy of that, a VTR videotape of the of some of the altercation, but I think we're all a little bit in the dark.
Bill, when I was when he was out in the ring having his match, this suitcase was lying down where he was. One of the guys happened to bump against it and it fell open. This is what I saw. Now, when he came back in the dressing room, I asked him, man to man, is this your suitcase? He says, what are you talking about? What are you talking about? I said, answer me, man. Is this your suitcase? Well, yes or no?
First of all, for the fans at home, there's a set of tights similar to what you wear. There's a couple of masks like yours. And this one, of course, has been doctored with paints to show a wounded mask. And there's a doll here. And
down the center of it.
This says wrestling. What does this say here? Wrestling 2, your pillow has been ordered so you can take your long overdue rest. I know your knee has lost its power, so don't hurt yourself anymore. And 2, you're a very confused man at this point. Don't worry, you will know when it hits you. And a lot of different things in here.
I'm seeing letters in here that I'm sure they're very appropriate for the man that wrote them. Let me tell you something, Bill. You know, known me for a long time, man. I'm a straight-up guy. I don't pull punches one way or the other with anybody. I tell it like it is, no matter who it hurts. And this, of all people, I cannot believe that Olympia is the man behind all this. But the obvious thing is that these are my masks. This is my clothes. This is the paint that he's been cluttering with. Hey,
well,
let's show that
altercation just a second, and again, let's try to collect our thoughts while that's going on, because although there's a preponderance of evidence right here, let's wait until, you know, there's two sides to every story, and I think even the fans, there's maybe more to this than meets the eye. If Oral Link will show that while he's showing it, let's calm down and collect ourselves a little bit here. Time to calm down a little bit. I know just how much this has bothered you. I think I know it more than anybody, because we have known each other for a long time, and you are a straight-up guy, and you've told me just how this has upset you and your whole family. But also, this is the United States, and in the United States, you know, there's two sides to every story, and I think somebody is innocent until proven guilty, and we haven't had a chance yet to question Mr. Olympia. And Mr. Olympia, if you recall, when you got injured from a situation around this same property situation with Akbar and Kamala, he's the one that volunteered and took your place with Stagger Lee. And he was forced to leave, and he hadn't even been here. And now here he's second week back. It looks like you say, certainly we can see the evidence is here. But I think, you know, let's give it a time, and let's wait. And what we'll do, he's scheduled to wrestle next. We'll, after his match, we'll get him out here, we'll confront him with this, and we'll hear his side of it. I think that first, I would like to congratulate you both on that great victory over DiBiase and Bourne, and I understand, I certainly understand.
Well, thank you very much, Bill. I appreciate it.
Okay, we'll be back after these messages from Mid-South. We promised you we'd talk to Mr. Olympia, and Mr. Olympia, I know you're upset about this. You voiced to me during the commercial break, but I do have to say and state the facts. This is your suitcase.
Bill, I don't know what's going on. I've been gone. For 60 long days, I've been gone, and now here this comes up. I took Wrestling 2's place.
I know that.
Out of the bottom of my heart, I took his place.
Let's just answer the question. Is this your suitcase? That's what he meant. Is this your suitcase?
Yes, that's my suitcase. Obviously, somebody else has put something in it, though.
Well, there's a lot of things. You've never seen any of this paraphernalia?
I don't know. I don't know how this got here. I hadn't done any of that. That's my suitcase, but I had other things in it.
Well, certainly, I don't see anything that
I don't
recognize
see how
as yours.
The man can blame me for something like this. Because I stood behind JYD through thick and thin, and Wrestling 2 got hurt right here on TV, and I took his place. Out of the goodness of my heart, I've had to take a vacation 60 long days. But let me tell you something, 2, or no matter who it is, I don't back down from nobody.
Well,
I'm not backing up. So if 2 don't lay off me,
yeah.
I'm going to tell you, it's going to be trouble, because I'm not going to back
well,
up.
Well, I know that in the heat of the moment that both of you are upset, and you both got a right. He naturally, I think you could understand, under the persecution he's been under, and certainly you being falsely accused, I can understand.
I don't know what's going on.
No, I
have no idea. I've been gone. I don't know what the man's been going through, but now he's blaming me for it.
We did want to get you out here and in front of everybody ask you, and you've denied any of these in there. I don't see any of your personal belongings in here, and certainly a lot of things have happened. We saw the things Paul Orndorff pulled. We saw the things Ted DiBiase. So we've seen a lot of things happen here. We've seen the things Hacksaw Dugan pulled. So somebody could definitely be at the bottom of this besides you. And certainly, I want to believe that, as does everybody here and everybody at home. I'd say this. Let's let a week go by. Let's both
hit the beat.
Well, at this particular point here, I was pretty well exhausted from trying to handle two men at different times where they both try to double up on me. He tried to ram me in there, but I reversed it. Coming off that one knee.
There's your knee lift. You got you out of the hole right there.
Sure, it certainly does. It always comes in handy right at the right moment.
Here you tag in Tiger.
Tiger Conway.
That's right. As I came in, you know, I knew only one thing I had to do was get the job done. And I was ready. And I tell you, I never felt as good as I felt then. And I tell you, I brought it to
Here's DiBiase. He drew the referee, more or less, because he knew 2 would come and the referee would intercept him. But 2 came on anyway, because you guys are fighting for your life right here.
That's right. You know, I headbutted him, and I didn't know what had happened. All I knew, I just got hit from the back.
Well, he connected on you pretty good.
And I'll tell you, you know, it was a feeling when I hit that turnbuckle. That took some of it out of me, too. The breath was out of me. And by the time, I tell you, I got it together, I looked up, and there he was.
Matt Bourne trying to put you away with his bombs away, but fortunately you got out of the way, and then the man, the living legend, Wrestling 2, you're coming right in doing what you know best, fighting that type of fight.
Well, that's exactly right. You know, when I saw the men coming, all I could think about was smash, bam, keep it going, and just...
Look at that. There he is.
That's that victory roll.
You pulled it out with that victory roll.
Pulled it right out right there.
What a time. Wrestling 2's got the way cleared, and you've got the man pinned.
That's right. All I was waiting for. I knew I had him 1, 2, 3, and man, I tell you, that was it.
When I heard those people explode, that popped the goose pimples all over my body because I knew we were.
Oh, they're going 2-2-2. And of course, you were like a sergeant at arms there. You cleared Ted DiBiase out and you were looking for Dugan or anybody else that may be coming. You are the champions. They may think they have underestimated you. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't think. I think this is the team to beat right here because they definitely are the champions. They hold the medal, and they got to come to you.
How sweet it is. Let me tell you, Bill, I'm looking forward to meeting anyone at any given time, any kind of tag team combination. I don't care who it may be. You line them up, and Conway and I will strike them out.
Well, I'm sure that there's going to be a lot of action like bees to a hive of honey. There's some new champions, and everybody's going to want to try you on for size. And I'm sure matchmaker Grizzly Smith and the promoters in the Mid-South area will be having a busy time, and you're going to have some very formidable opponents.
The Rat Pack is grumbling, boss.
The Rat Pack is hurting. We'll be back after these moments and these messages from Mid-South.